Kinumalala. Mataas yung growth rate ng cement sector, di ba? There are only 3 corporations in the cement sector with 98% ng capacity. Cemex, Lafarge, saka Wholesale. All foreign companies, all benefited from the boom, pero none of whom are actually local firms na nakintegrate sa local economy natin. So even yung boom times na yan, did not create domestic manufacturing capacity. Yung chemical sector natin, the chemical sector is the second most import-intensive sector sa Pilipinas next to electronics. Bakit? Kasi nga, wala naman tayong basic chemical industries. So kihalin natin even yung supposed growth sa manufacturing sectors, which were real estate construction driven, they were not creating domestic capacity because foreign transnational corporations dominated all those sectors and they're very import-intensive sectors. So in the end, ano nangyari na sa atin? After we had the 3 to 5 years ng boom times because of low interest rates, because of real estate construction, once interest rates start increasing, bababa na yung demand for those, bababa yung production for that, and the economy is left with the same backward agriculture it's always had, the economy is left with the same backward manufacturing it's always had, at ito yung point na slide na yan, dapat inulit yung line na namin. Pero yung pababa na lines na yan, they reflect the lowest manufacturing share in the economy since the 1950s and the lowest agriculture share in the economy in its entire history. So in the end, yun ang gusto na highlight, yun ang point ng unsustainability. Artificial siya because interest rate, low interest rate driven. Unsustainable kasi in the course of the boom, we did not create a domestic foundation in demand or a domestic foundation in production. So in the end, pagkatapos nga na, in the same way na nawala na yung hype about the BRICS, mawawala din yung hype about the CAP and the things natin. We think it's important to highlight, again, even announcements by the government, they've been saying that they will be releasing, they're learning though from the problems of not inclusive growth over the last 3 years. So the government said they'll be announcing updated Philippine Development Plan this January. They said they'll be announcing industrial roadmaps to develop domestic industry this month. What are our problems with that? Well, again, the details are in the paper, but the core problems is they do not learn from the mistakes. Siyempre, when they rewrote it, they acknowledged the problem of low job generation, increasing poverty, they acknowledged the problem of lack of support for domestic industry. But what they do not do is they do not actually change the policy measures that have been implemented since the Arroyo time up until the Aquino time right now. We still have the same problems of austerity, we still have the same problems for bias to foreign investment, we still have the same problems of no land reform, no wage hikes because it affects the economy and all that. The Philippine Development Plan is updated with rhetoric, but it's not updated in content. Again, paliwanag na lang piece of the paper. Industrial roadmaps are a bit tricky. Industrial roadmaps, they're actually very good to read. If you look at industrial roadmaps, it lists so many things that the government should be doing to develop industry. It mentions subsidies, it mentions tax breaks, it mentions better infrastructure, it mentions facilitating the bureaucracy and all that. But what it's not mentioned is that the main beneficiaries of that will be foreign transnational corporations. Bakit? Very revealing. The process of drawing industrial roadmaps, ang ginawa ng government, participatory to, bottom up. They went to the transnational corporations, nag-workshop sila, asked them, what do you want? What support can we give you? Minersya at TNCs yan, they came out with their roadmaps across so many sectors, and it is submitted to the government, and the government, they receive the roadmaps na yon, and they're going to be calling it fancy name siya, which I keep forgetting. Ang fancy name niya ay the Comprehensive National Industrial Strategy. Dapat may alarm bells siya. Dapat may alarm bells. In 2009, yung Joint Foreign Chambers of Commerce in the Philippines, lobbying group ng transnational corporations by the advanced capitalist powers, in 2009, the Joint Foreign Chambers of the Philippines came out with a tawag nila 7 big winners. Isa sila ng mga sectors dyan. BPO, electronics, agribusiness, etc. 2009, ginawa nila yan. In 2010, nirepackage sila sa Arangkada. Nabalitaan nila pa ng Arangkada. Nirepackage sa Arangkada. In 2011, finally, matagumpay ang lobbying nila. Nailagay yung 7 big winners na yan sa Philippine Region Term Philippine Development Plan for 2011. So yung nagagalap ngayon, after the updating, yung matagal na nilalobby ng transnational corporations ay ginawa ng official government policy for the remaining 3 years of the Aquino term. Bakit yung problematic? Well, kasi after all the foreign investment ng country over the last decades, hindi naman tayo nakinabang to. Because clear na yung government policies natin for maximum profit for the foreign investors and minimum development gain for the Philippine economy. So I think very important highlight yan kasi this maganda pakinggan eh. And even in progressive groups, for the longest time, they say, dapat may itas yung development tayo. It's very deceitful yung paglabas ng updated Philippine Development Plan, which claims to be for inclusive growth, and deceitful industrial roadmap, which claims to be for developing Philippine industry, and all they will be developing is foreign transnational corporations based in the Philippines. Quick round to lang dun sa last point na yan. To highlight the lack of change in fundamental policies under the Aquino administration, the last year, 2015, has seen major steps by the Philippine government to increase the number of free trade agreements it enters into. In December, it supported the WTO trade facilitation agreement in its 9th ministerial. Essentially, it just facilitates imports from abroad and does not maybe facilitate Philippine exports to other countries. So, fully supported in the Philippine government, despite nakita ng internal documents sinasabi na magka-effect sa ating trade deficit. Pero despite that, the Philippine government supported the WTO trade facilitation agreement in December. In terms of the European Union Philippine free trade agreement, again, last year, nagkandara pa yung Philippine government, started a series of lobbying missions to the European Union's commissioner to restart the project, to restart the talks on the EURFTA. Medyo nag-dragged kasi for the last 2 years. Successful doon, the Philippine government targeted in November technical consultations to resume the EURFTA agreement. Ang very big step forward ngayon is the Trans-Pacific Partnership. Lumabas lang when Secretary of State Kerry came to the Philippines, who also announced that finally, after 3 years na nagbibig ng Philippines, we want to be part of TPP, consider us. Parang ano yun, sasabihin ng US Ambassador, yeah, but change your constitution first. Kasi din ang US State Representative, yeah, gold standard ng TPP, baka hindi nyo kaya. Pero after 3 years of lobbying the US government, nag-declare na yung United States and the Philippines, this January, a technical team from the Philippines, from DTI, will be attending consultations on Philippines' entry to the TPP nitong January. Supposedly, 3rd week of January yung pulo na yan. The whole point is lang is, ma-highlight yung continuing failure natin. The reason we have been so backward is agriculture has been falling, the reason Philippine manufacturing has been declining for these decades is because implementation of neoliberal policies. The Aquino administration in the last year, 2013, and we can expect in January 2014, will be reiterating the exact same policy measures that have caused the failure over the last decades. Ross, mag-inig na ng oras mo. Negative talaga siya. Ito nga yung naging pula, ang napaka-negative naman ng ipon. Nung na-highlight natin, balikan natin. We highlighted, despite the growth, it's been narrow and shallow, artificial and unsustainable, but increasing numbers of unemployed, underemployed, increasing number of poors, worsening agricultural backwardness, worsening industrial backwardness. Despite all that, yung pa rin ang policies na papuntapal administration in the remaining 3 years of this term. Big question sa atin dyan is what can be done? Well, actually, in a way, simple lang what can be done. Unang-una, iyan po na yung ginagawa dati. They've proven to be causing so much damage. What they do is stop it para you stop causing the damage and then take steps forward. Ito ay attempt na i-summarize kasi again, announced ko na i-advertise ko. Ibon will be conducting a lecture series on pro-people economics itong 2014 to detail in the whole range of policy measures that can be done to actually avert the continuing development failure. But I just want to highlight a couple of things using the arguments that we developed.